Russian. Rules the nation with Russian.
So here in BC, for sure, the biggest change I've really noticed in jiu-jitsu is just like the approach everyone's taking. Each team is so focused. We're trying to like build proper structure. When I started training, jiu-jitsu was like a random mixed bag of stuff when you showed up to class. It might be doing one random thing here, then a random technique from here. But now as you go around, all the schools are so structured, we're really setting up our students for success, and then you see it at tournaments all the time. You guys see the little kids dominating. You see the white belts playing positions that like blue and purples used to play when I started, and they play them really well. So, man, the level just keeps rising and rising and rising, especially because the community in BC is like getting closer and closer too, with a lot of younger school owners, that next generation, not tied up in like politics as much, just really good like jiu-jitsu and growth. It's always happening. So since opening Kaboom, I've really actually learned how important the approach to how you treat your student is. Like when I started my first class, I remember I wanted to quit immediately. I had a 30-minute warm-up. I walked in. I remember I told my friend, like, yo, let's just sneak out after the warm-up. And like the thing, if I didn't stay, you know, I might not be here for all these other years afterwards. So now with that in my mind, when I open Kaboom, I'm very conscious of that first sort of phase for that student when they're just getting into it. Because like it's that little nurturing phase, because if they can get through that initial, you know, that orientation, getting into the hardness, getting used to it, then they can get access to all the benefits that come at year one, two, three, and onward. So that's been the biggest thing that I've learned, is like setting up my students for success, helping them get to their goals by sort of helping them ease in and like, you know, that little immersion process, little by little, and just making it happen that way. That's been the biggest thing I've learned for sure, how to set the student up.
Feeling. Love you like a fresh vegetable. So tell me if you love Tony Rebel. Me love you like a fresh vegetable. So tell me if you love Tony Rebel. Because you want to let me roll.
That was good. It was for me, I like that. It's submission only. So you don't gotta worry about the points, getting swept or anything. At the end of the day, he's going to get the submission, and that's my type of tournament. So, well, at that point, you know, he was breathing quite heavy. I got about 10 pounds on Philippe, so I got to use my weight to my advantage, right? And being on top and putting a little bit of the weight on him, right? I could feel that he was breathing heavy, so it's good. You know, I thought that I'd be able to take his back a little faster, I guess. And he actually defended it quite well. So I had to kind of play it out a bit and use the X guard instead of just the De La Hiva to take it back. And eventually it worked out in my favor, so. MMA is my focus. I think in September I was supposed to be a part of, it might be controversial, but I was supposed to be a part of an event in grappling, but you know, an MMA fight came up. I've been trying to get a 185 fight for like the last year. I think I've had one, so I have one coming up, so I'm gonna definitely go MMA first priority. But I like to love competing in anything, whether it's boxing, jiu-jitsu, you know, I just mixed martial artists, right? I'll take any comer type.